What is 1 Weber? Weber is an unit of magnetic flux, and also, for magnetic pole strength. It is named after famous German physicist, Wilhelm Eduard Weber. In this tutorial, we shall define 1 Weber by using Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, which says, if you move an electric loop near a magnet, then an electromotive force, or electric potential, will be generated throughout the loop. You may detect the instantaneous potential difference by a voltmeter attached to it. The incidence is known as electromagnetic induction. The reason behind this induction is the changes in magnetic flux through the loop. When the loop moves, the number of field lines passed through it changes. Hence, an electromotive force generated in the loop. But, when it stops, no change occurs. And therefore, the voltmeter shows a null reading. At a distant point from the magnet, where movements of the loop do not produce any electromotive force, is called a zero flux region. And the surface may be termed as a zero Weber surface. Now, move the loop towards the magnet at some uniform velocity. See, there is an electromotive force. Take a slow motion. Now, suppose, after a time span of 1 second, the loop reaches that point. And the voltmeter reading shows a 1 volt potential difference. Then the magnetic flux attached to this loop area is called 1 Weber. If you move the loop faster, the voltmeter may show a 2 volt reading after 1 second. Then the magnetic flux through that surface is 2 Weber. A 3 Weber, 4 Weber can also be shown in this way. Remember, the loop in this case is a single turn one, not multi-turn. So, what we learn from this? 1 Weber is the amount of magnetic flux attached to a single turn loop when the loop approaches a magnet in 1 second from a zero flux zone to induce a 1 volt electromotive force in it. Magnetic flux and magnetic fields are invisible. Magnetic flux are typically described as some imaginary magnetic field lines. When these lines pass perpendicularly through a surface, it is called the magnetic flux through the surface. More field lines indicates more flux or more Weber. If you move a surface about a magnetic field, the value of the magnetic flux may change. Again, if you increase the surface area, the flux value should be higher. Magnetic flux depends on the area of the surface. More surface area means more Weber. When you measure flux value through a surface of exactly 1 square meter, then it is expressed in Tesla. When a magnetic flux of amount 1 Weber pass perpendicularly through a surface of area exactly 1 square meter, then the magnetic field at this location is called 1 Tesla. The unit, Weber, is used to describe the total magnetic flux through a surface of any size. The surface may be either large or small, but Tesla defines the magnetic flux at some specific location through a unit surface area. More Tesla means more powerful magnetic field. Weber does not give any idea about the strength of a field. If you cover a magnetic pole by some imaginary closed surface, then you might be able to find out the total flux emitted from the pole. It is called the magnetic pole strength of the magnet. And SI unit of the magnetic pole strength is Weber as well. Here, on this paper, you can find magnetic field strengths of some typical magnetic objects. Compare the data to realize how bigger or smaller 1 Tesla is. Hope you realized the topic. Tell me in the comment box if you have cleared your doubt on this topic. See you in our next tutorial. For now, let me say goodbye.